quickly going to pull out some of the more obvious elements of this story, a very basic deconstruction. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure by a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending as a state of perfection, which is lost, becomes the state of imperfection, the lost phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there, or somewhere in between. If you do that, then the events there tend to be referenced at later stages. Most stories, such as this one, end with some form of state of perfection. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, psychological journey, the various arcs, transmogrification. You're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which are physical manifestations of new versions of the self, new psychological states. In this story, we have one major location that's sectioned using various tools. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated. They tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you are here, you're not ready to return. You are unable to right the wrong, so you have to go forward. You have to grow, learn, mature, let go of your older limitations, gain capacities, come back round until you are ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based upon, and we go over that in great detail on the website in the 2000 plus stage Hero's Journey. Now, let's get rid of that. Let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle represents. So the state of perfection has been lost. A crime has been committed. The accused has had lived in a rough neighborhood, been beaten up all his life. So we're coming into it, into the imperfect state, in the lost phase. And we're coming into a new world. So the camera pulls us in through the doors, into the building, the courthouse, the courtroom, and then we follow the men into the room. We have a minor threshold guardian, which in essence is the judge saying, I need a unanimous vote, guilty or not guilty, and if it's guilty, then the man's going to be put to death, so a man's life is going to come to an end. So we're coming into the room, and we're in our ordinary world, our ordinary state, classic containment symbolism, so we're locked in there until we have grown, and it's only when we have grown that we will be able to transcend that world, in other words, be let out. We're benchmarking our various arcs, so we've got the deficient self. So the men are talking baseball, they're talking about their jobs, they're not taking the situation seriously, they're not appreciating the gravity of it, they're not appreciating that they're putting a man's life to death, so they in essence are inhuman. And that's one of the arcs that we're going to progress through, so we're going to become more human. We've got polarity and division, we've got Henry Fonda standing apart. And as we progress, other men are going to take his side. So that's another arc that we'll progress through. We basically have our call to adventure, which is Henry Fonda voting not guilty. He at this moment, he's not sure. Later, he will be sure. So that's one of his arcs. And we have refusal in that the men are unwilling to change their minds. And that word change is used quite a bit. So the whole story is about the resistance to change and overcoming of that. So then we board a symbolism into our first threshold. So this is, okay, let's get going. We've got dialogue such as stop being a kid. Now the journey is a metaphor for maturity, so that references our, we're going to lose the older, more childish self and become the mature new self. So then we start stripping away the evidence on a very superficial level, and separation comes when Henry Fonda pulls out an identical knife and another juror takes his side. And then we have the toilet scene, in essence the belly of the whale, and so this is the men adamant that they're not going to change, and Henry Fonda himself has his own limitation. What if he's wrong? What if he persuades all the men that the boy is innocent, he's set free, and he really did kill his father? So in that section, we've got just a slight incremental pulling away, stripping away of the evidence, and incremental stripping away of the older self. Physical separation when we really get going and start to do it on a deeper level. So that, in essence, is the road of trials. So we strip away the evidence, we work at it on a much deeper level, and as we strip it away, we're stripping away our older selves, and we're stripping away our older inhumanity, and we're pulling away from the early benchmark positions of our arc, till we come all the way around, season of tangible sword, so the return of hope, in essence. So this is now 6 votes not guilty against 6 guilty. And the intangible sword, the Latino gentleman's impassioned speech about the value of democracy, the value of our laws. So we are becoming more human. Near-death experience, in essence, you can see that visually. The most aggressive juror holds a knife up to Henry Fonda's chest, about to kill him, all the way around some atonement. And underlying all this has been hate in the form of prejudice, and so that's faced. And the men turn their backs on that. They turn their backs on their innermost fear. So we're apotheosing out of that state. So in essence, we have become human. So that is one form of the boon. We had Henry Fonda here. Here he's not sure. He just wants to talk about it. Now he is sure. He stands up and he says, we 9 cannot understand how you 3 who are voting guilty can be so sure. So that's one of his arcs. He's also overcome his earlier limitation in that he's gotten over the fact that he might be wrong. He's now sure that there's reasonable doubt and what the right thing to do is. There we basically got our limitations, which is the final 3 jurors, and then the final conflict, which is the last juror. In essence, it's all about letting go. Let's go off the fact that his son isn't speaking to him, and that the accused is a metaphor for his own son, and then we come back round to state of imperfection, state of perfection. So the accused is set free, so we've got our liberty back. And also in the final scene, Henry Fonda is asked his name. Now the journey is a metaphor for finding out who you are, and so that references the fact that we have found out who we are. So that's a very basic deconstruction. If you want a detailed deconstruction, you can order it off the website. But once again, showing you that all these stories follow the 2,000 plus dead hero's journey and transformation, moving through new worlds and states, which we go over on the website, which you can purchase off the website.